TCP is a protocol that is used to establish a connection between two devices, such as a computer and a website. It ensures that the data is transferred reliably by using something called error recovery. To establish a connection, the devices need to go through a process called the three-way handshake. The three-way handshake consists of three steps. 1. The first device sends a message called a SYN or synchronize message to the other device, asking to start a connection. 2. The second device receives the SYN message and sends back a message called a SYN-ACK or synchronize and acknowledge message, saying that it is ready to start the connection. 3. The first device receives a SYN-ACK message and sends back an ACK or acknowledge message, confirming that the connection has been established. When the devices have completed their communication, the connection is terminated by going through another process called the four-way handshake. The four-way handshake consists of four steps. 1. The first device sends a FIN or finish message to the other device, indicating that it wants to end the connection. 2. The second device receives the FIN message and sends back an ACK or acknowledge message, confirming that it has received the FIN message and the connection will be closed. 3. The second device sends its own FIN message to the first device, indicating that it also wants to end the connection. 4. The first device receives the second device's FIN message and sends an ACK message, confirming that it has received the FIN message and the connection is closed. TCP establishes and terminates connections between endpoints, whereas UDP does not. Therefore, UDP is called a connectionless protocol. It provides no reliability, no windowing, and no reordering of the data. However, UDP does provide data transfer and multiplexing using port numbers, and it does so with fewer bytes of overhead and less processing than TCP. Applications that use UDP, such as VoIP, trade the possibility of some data loss for less delay. This figure compares the two headers. TCP header. Typically 20 bytes in length. Contains sequence and acknowledgement numbers to ensure reliable delivery of data. The sequence number identifies the order in which data is sent, and the acknowledgement number confirms the receipt of data. Uses flow control to regulate the amount of data that is sent to prevent network overload. It slows down the transmission rate if the network is congested. Has a checksum for error detection, which ensures that data is not corrupted during transmission. Includes flags that indicate the type of TCP segment, such as SYN, AFIN, ARIST, PESH, and ACK, which control the establishment and termination of a connection and the flow of data. UDP header. Typically 8 bytes in length. Does not provide reliable delivery, no sequence or acknowledgement numbers. This makes UDP faster, but with a higher risk of data loss or corruption. No flow control or congestion control. This makes UDP unsuitable for applications that require reliable delivery, but ideal for time-sensitive applications such as online gaming, video conferencing, and streaming. Has a checksum for error detection, which can detect corruption of data, but does not guarantee that the data will be corrected or resent. Does not have flags or any mechanism for controlling the flow of data. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out the rest of our CCNA course series, all available for free. Follow us on social media to stay updated and be a part of the community. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. See you in the next video. Until next time, farewell and happy studying.